Hi friends, welcome to the course Words to Use Instead of Very, presented by me, Amirtha Devarajan. I'm a student of English Literature from Delhi University. You can follow me on Unacademy at this given URL, and don't forget to rate, review, recommend, share and comment on my videos. Please provide me with your valuable feedback. I'm waiting your response like anything. Okay, so let's start with the word very little or tiny. Well, I'm sure both these words are, you are familiar with both these words. Tiny is something very small in size, and very little again means the same. So the meaning is very small. Look at this tiny house. So this is so tiny that it fits into a hand. So this is a tiny house, and it's an adjective. It's used to describe nouns. For example, if I'm saying tiny house, then tiny is the adjective because it's describing the noun house. It's a synonym, the synonyms for this is bit again is, agar hum bolte hain, chota bit. So bit is a small part. So bitty is a small part that is again very small, and microscopic is something which has to be seen through a microscope. So when do you see something through a microscope? When something is tiny. So again, you can use the words bitty, microscopic and tiny for the word very little. Moving on, let's see the examples. The computer chips were tiny. He's from a tiny town that you've probably never heard of. There's just one tiny problem. So, you know, in all these contexts, the word tiny has been used differently to show something which is very small. The second word is very messy or slovenly. Slovenly basically means very messy, very untidy. This is slovenly. It's an adjective used to describe nouns. And synonym for this is slobbish. So the word for very untidy or very messy is slovenly and slobbish. Moving on, let's see the examples. He dressed in a slovenly manner. So he dressed in a very untidy and a very messy manner. He transformed from a clean-cut lad to a slovenly rock star. Well, if you've seen the movie Rockstar, in which Ranbir Kapoor is starred, I mean, in which the lead is Ranbir Kapoor, you see first he's a clean lad. He's a clean-shaved lad, and then he transforms into a slovenly rock star. Messy, with messy clothes and hair flying all over, with beard and everything. So you call that look a messy look, right? So he had a slovenly looking rock star, and usually all the rock stars have slovenly looks. Moving on, very talented. Very talented, the word for very talented is gifted. And gifted, what does talented mean? We call someone talented when they have some talent, because they have some specialization in something. For example, if I'm good at drawing, you may say that she's talented. She's very talented. She has natural ability to draw. She's a very talented artist. You may call me, if I'm a talented singer, if I sing very well, you may say that she's a very talented singer. You may call someone a talented writer if they write very well, if they express themselves very well. You may call someone an expressive or talented poet. So talented is you use the word talented when someone specializes in something and someone is extremely and exceedingly creative in some field. For example, I can call this old man a talented, you know, artist. Meaning is to have a great natural ability. It's an adjective used to describe noun. Synonym is genius. Well, he's a genius in writing. He's a genius in singing. He's simply a genius in sports. So in that sense, this is used. So the word for talented is gifted. So when do you use talented? When someone has a natural ability. So that means God has given you, gifted you some kind of talent. So you can say gifted instead of very talented. So I can say that she's a gifted teacher. She teaches so well and she imparts knowledge so well. So I can say that. I can say he's a gifted singer. He has a gifted voice. His voice is so nice and versatile. So it is used in that sense. So I can say Arijit Singh is a gifted singer. I hope the context is clear. Let's look at the examples. He's an extremely gifted student. Sorry, I missed out Anne. So when I say this, I mean that as a student, his capabilities as a student is really good. He's excellent as a student because he does all his work on time and he studies well. So in that case, I can use the word gifted. A school for gifted children. So here I mean gifted here could have been, you know, in different contexts. For example, gifted I mean call those people who are differently abled, and also those who are, you know, very talented in a special school for them. So it can be used in multi contexts. Let's next move on to the next word. very frightened or alarmed. We've already done the word very frightening, and it is different from the word very frightened. Very frightened is bahut dar jana, and very frightening is something, some situation, some incident which is very frightening, jo bahut khatarnak ho. And frightened is when aap dar jao. So the word for it is alarmed. Well, look at this man. He's alarmed at seeing the fire. He's frightened. He's petrified. He's scared. So this is the how this is word used. This word is used. Meaning is to strike with fear, to shiver with fear. It's a verb. Verbs are action words like walk, talk, sleep. Anything which you do is verb. If I'm talking to you, I'm talking. Action word, hence a verb. So the synonym is affright. So the word for very frightened, you know, you can remember it in this manner. We have fright, frightened, frightened, frightened. Fright basically means dar. And just put AF, that is a fright, and you can learn this word. So instead of saying frightened, use the word affright or alarmed. Let's look at the examples. She was alarmed at the sight of such destruction. So she was very frightened to see such destruction in front of her. The rapid spread of the disease has alarmed many people. They are frightened. Well, whenever this dengue comes in the monsoon season, we're all frightened, we're alarmed, and we are very cautious not to, you know, open the windows after 6 p.m. So this is being alarmed. Where is an alarm used? An alarm clock is used to wake you up. So in this context, you're waking up from something very serious. So frightened is alarmed. Ab hosh aata hai and we're all very scared. Moving on, the last word is very neat or immaculate. Immaculate basically means perfectly clean. If you're saying that, okay, you look immaculate, then I mean that you're spotless, you have nothing dirty in you, you're just simply very, very clean or perfectly clean. It's an adjective used to describe nouns. Synonym is pure, clean. Now look at this picture, this looks immaculate. Don't notice this, I mean this guy has, you know, done his work, and this place now looks immaculate, very neat, clean, perfectly clean. Let's look at the examples. She had an immaculate record of service. She has a very clean record, a crystal clear record of service she had. Somehow managed to keep the white carpet immaculate. Well, usually the white carpets go dirty, and it's very hard to maintain something as pure as white. I mean, if I'm wearing a white gown or white dress, then it's hard to retain its color. It fades after some point of time. So in order to maintain its immaculate shine, it's hard. So that is what it's been said here, that somehow they managed to keep the white carpet immaculate, perfectly clean. So guys, the session ends here. But before we sign off, let's just do a quick recap of what we did today. The first word we learned today was very tiny, very little is tiny, very messy is slovenly, very frightened is alarmed, very neat is immaculate, and very talented is gifted or genius. And you can also use the word slobbish instead of very messy. I have mentioned this earlier, but I just wanted to remind you once again. Please note these words down. We will also be having revision sessions later, so don't worry about it. But yeah, please retain these words in your memory. Thank you guys. Have a nice day.